So I'm halfway done with the video. Then I get a notification and a few phone calls while I'm away from my phone. So I stop what I'm doing, of course, to check to see what happened. And to my knowledge, I find out Boogie Cousins just signed with the Los Angeles Lakers. So I'm like, damn, he just tipped the scales, ladies and gentlemen. But hey, this bit of information, it caused me to start the video all over again. Yeah, big waste of my time. But I guess you could say it's well worth it. If you're new to the channel, please hit that sub button. Also drop a like for your boy. Now let's talk about this crazy ass free agency that's been going on for these past couple of days. Drop my intro. It's Killer Raps, we got the hottest stats. In 03, I made a dynasty like Robert Kraft. Listen, man, I don't even know where to start, y'all. I mean, I just don't know. But all I can say is the NBA is bike. No more Christmas in August. It's back in December, ladies and gentlemen. This will be the best NBA season we've seen in almost a decade. So much has happened over the past week that I stopped making videos. Look, I just needed some time to gather my thoughts because this is crazy. First of all, Kawhi held everybody hostage with this move. So let's give a hand clap to Kawhi. Hell of a chess move, my dude. No one knew where he was gonna go. Well, except me, because if y'all part of the OG gang, y'all probably remember when I said this. The LA Clippers have a whole lot of cap space, right? There isn't a player on their roster making anything worth talking about. So they can afford to actually go after two marquee free agents next season. Kawhi has already mentioned that he wanted to play in LA and he also preferred the Clippers over the Lakers. So the Clippers could instantly go from a team that was in rebuild mode to title contenders in just a few short seasons. Listen, man, I was just taking a guess, just like everybody else was, but it ended up happening. Kawhi is a Clipper and the story is told as follows. See, he wanted to play in LA before LeBron went to the Lakers, so everybody thought he was gonna team up with him. But Kawhi is a man that marches to his own beat. Very composed, very concealed, very collected. He forced the Clippers' hand to trade for all-star Paul George if they wanted to be accompanied by his services. That's exactly what they did. Pairing these two lethal defenders together will be trouble for the league. But the thing is with that, normally, this would be the highlight of free agency, but there have been so many more moves that was made, I don't know who the favorite is. So is it solidified for the Clippers to win a championship? I don't think so. All of these teams look so different now, guys, man. I don't even know where to start. But as we all know, Kawhi went to the Clippers and he was joined by Paul George. Kevin Durant signed with Brooklyn to pair up with Kyrie Irving. Jimmy Butler wanted his own team to create his own legacy, so he signed with the Miami Heat. Can't be mad at that. Shout out to my man's Jimmy Buckets. Kemba Walker signed with Boston to take Kyrie's place, and they also brought in a scoring big but defensive liability, Enes Kanter, who I love. May sound like an oxymoron, but it is what it is. Al Horford signed with the Sixers to pair with Embiid and Harris to compete out east. We all know the Lakers traded for AD a couple weeks ago to complement LeBron, but they also plugged in and acquired Boogie Cousins and Danny Green, while also re-signing Rondo for two more seasons. And oh man, Hassan Whiteside was traded to Portland to add more depth to that front court that was hindered with injuries last season. Shout out to my man D Rose, cause he got his shot to start again. Detroit signed him to a 2-year deal. I can't wait to see what happens with that. Think it's great for the former MVP. Give him Drummond and Griffin? It's gonna be nice to see next season. Golden State had to do something. With the departure of Kevin Durant, they had to do something. So they panic signed D'Angelo Russell. Made no sense to me, but hey, we'll see how it works. A couple other cats stayed with their teams also. Guys like Chris Middleton, Klay Thompson, Tobias Harris, Nikola Vucevic, Kristaps Porzingis all decided to stay long term. I mean, I like those moves for those guys. They deserve it. And lots of other guys will have opportunities to prove what they can do next season. Guys like Ricky Rubio, whom of which I think is the most underrated signing in this free agency. I like Rubio's leadership, and I think his play style fits well with Phoenix and what they're trying to do with their young squad, DeAndre Ayton and Devin Booker. My man Scary Terry say, hey, get me the hell up out of here. He took Kemba's place in Charlotte, and now he gets the chance to prove what he can do. The Knicks signed Julius Randle and a bunch of other irrelevant pieces to the... Look, man. Through all of this, it's two people I feel sorry for. The New York Knicks and Russell Westbrook. No one seems to want to play with these two. The Knicks had their hopes all year, telling their fan base they bringing in some type of big free agent next season. Zion Williamson, the whole nine, they struck out with the bases knotted and a 3-0 count. I mean, they missed out on, like I said, Zion, Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving, and Kawhi Leonard. Sucks to be a New York Knicks fan right now, man. Damn, that's messed up. But it's rumored that OKC will be blowing that team up, which means Russell Westbrook could be on the move. As a matter of fact, they in talks as we speak with his agent, trying to find out possible trading destinations. Not a big Westbrook fan, but I wish him the best wherever he goes. Now, y'all don't know how hype I am right now. Just talking about this gives me goosebumps, y'all. We got our league back. So many new faces and so many new places. I want to talk about what things gonna look like next year for a second. Brooklyn's starting five will be Kyrie, three-point champ Joe Harris, Kevin Durant, Taurean Prince, and DeAndre Jordan. Sheesh. Boston's lineup ain't looking that bad either. It's gonna be Kemba Walker, Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, Gordon Hayward, and Enes Kanter. Looking forward to see that. Philly gonna have Simmons at the one, Josh Richardson at the two, Tobias Harris at the three, Al Horford at the four, and of course, Joel Embiid at the five. Now that right there is straight nasty. Oh, my God. Lakers look like they gonna have a squad of their own too, man. Rondo at the one, Danny Green at the two, LeBron at the three, AD at the four, and Boogie fucking Cousins at the five. This right here, on paper, yeah, it's probably the best starting five in the league to me. So in the comments, y'all let me know who got the best starting five on paper right here, right now, man. Y'all let me know what y'all think. But execution is key, though. But damn, them names sound good. Last but not least, we got the Clippers. Pat Bev at the one, Paul George at the two, Kawhi Leonard at the three, Montrezl Harrell going, I know he came off the bench last year, but he gonna have to start this year at the four, with Zubac at the five, who I think a lot of people sleeping on. Zubac is quality, man, straight up. But that's how the league is looking right now as of July 7th, 2019, man. More moves could come, we just gotta wait and see. But I tell you one thing, barring injury from anyone, next season could be the best NBA season of all time. Not only if Kevin Durant can wake up tomorrow with Usain Bolt's Achilles tendon, or Klay Thompson could pop out of bed with the knees of a yoga instructor, we'd all be all good. But even with that situation at hand, we still got some good stuff happening next season. Well, anyways, that's pretty much all I got for you guys. Please leave a like if you enjoyed this video. Also, subscribe to the channel if you love sports the way that I do. Don't forget to hit that notification bell, be part of the OG gang, all that good stuff. Y'all already know what it is, but man, I can't wait. I feel like a kid in a candy store, man. Football is around the corner, so my life will be back in order very shortly. Seems to be trending in the right direction. But anyways, it's been a doozy, y'all, and as always, OG out.